everybody. Welcome back to Bops and Bangers. I am Kelsey.
And I'm Ashley.
And we, this year, have been so good at introducing ourselves.
We have.
Hot out the gate.
Every single podcast that I've watched, which is all of them, we're good at. I hope.
We did it. We've learned our lessons from the past 100 seasons, and we're getting better.
We're getting better. Yeah, we just started off.
We just immediately have to say our names. Otherwise, we start tangenting.
Yeah, no, it was perfect.
Tangenting?
Tangent.
Tangenting.
Mm. Oh, yeah. I don't like that. I got it. My brain just like shut down immediately. I was like,
I saw your eyeball go, mm-mm.
Anyways, hello. Thank you for being here and coming to watch Bops and Bangers.
Yeah, it's a super fun podcast where we talk
or
about...
Or listen.
Oh, or listen.
Yeah. I can't forget about the listening piece.
We can't. I'm such a viewer, but
yeah.
We hope you enjoy. This is a wonderful music podcast where we talk all about the hot takes of the music industry. We also discover new music with each other. Oftentimes, Ashley's telling me about albums I've never heard of, and oftentimes vice versa.
Yeah, you got a few on your list today that I haven't listened to.
Oh, girl, you are in for a treat, and I feel like I'm in for a treat.
Oh, yeah.
So buckle in, boys. Let's get the show on the road. Our first hot take, obviously, we have to talk about Coachella.
Yes.
This will be coming out a little bit later, but... I know you guys still care. Everyone still cares. We have to talk about the Frank Ocean debacle.
Forever.
Yeah.
We have to talk about...
I mean, people are going to be caring about that for years.
That's what I'm saying. We have to talk about Fred again. We have to talk about just Coachella in general. So let's hop into it as I fluff my hair.
Fluff it. I will say that none of us went to Coachella.
No.
So we don't know really what went down, but...
With the rise of social media and TikTok, I feel
we
like
kind
we
of
do.
Know.
We know enough.
We do know.
We know enough. I did some deep diving.
Deep diving.
I think it's really interesting. Okay, so everyone knows Frank Ocean pulled out of Weekend 2. No shocker there. The second the Weekend 1... like vids started hitting TikTok. I was like, this man's not coming back. He's not coming back.
I thought that too. You know, I feel so bad. I really,
I have opposite feelings about that.
Really?
Yeah. Of course I'm empathetic with his brother died, I think like 6 months ago.
It's only 6 months?
It's been pretty recent, right, Rich? Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think
yeah,
so.
Yeah, I don't think it's like 6 months though, but it's been a minute.
Okay.
But yeah, he's been through like some...
He's been through some shitty things.
Yeah.
And I think... That is, I get it.
Yeah.
But you are signing the contract to play at Coachella.
Yeah.
You have to understand that responsibility therein lies on you.
And he hasn't performed in years.
Years.
So like what?
He passed away like 3 years ago.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay. Okay.
So what though?
Ashley loves to eat the mic.
So what though, like made him sign the contract to perform Coachella.
I mean, that's the biggest
thing. Do we think
thing.
It's money? Do we think... He did mention in like a speech, like when he was talking on stage, that him and his brother used to come there together.
Oh. Yeah.
And they used to enjoy Coachella, and it's like such an honor to be on the stage.
I heard he signed the deal. The whole thing of it is that he signed the deal during the pandemic, like before his brother, right before,
because
his brother passed, I think, in fall of 2020, a pandemic.
Oh.
And so he signed it right before that.
Okay.
And so that was already a thing. And when I went to Coachella last year,
yeah,
all the buzz was, we already know Frank's playing.
I remember that too.
And so, and then the people that were working there were like, we know Frank's going to headline. So it's kind of was already, you know.
But you can still back out of it far in advance.
I was just
clear. No, I get that. I, you know, I'm like, devil's advocate. I sympathize with mental health and Frank Ocean. I get it. But bro, you had how many years to back out? You know, you could have. And my whole, this is maybe my dark side of thinking.
We love when that happens.
Do we? I really do believe that it wasn't up to his par of what a show should be.
Yes.
And because that ice rink thing got canceled or whatever it may be. And I think
didn't he pull the plug on that? Because he hurt his ankle?
his ankle. The man was jumping around that Coachella stage.
Oh, that's true, yeah.
And he came on an hour late. Yeah. People are flying across the fucking world to come and see this man.
Yes. That's kind of the biggest thing. And he knows this.
Yeah.
And he knows his fans are dedicated.
You couldn't see him.
And you couldn't see him. He played a weird DJ set for 10 minutes. He wasn't even singing his own song.
Which is, people come for his voice, because my God, he can sing.
My God, I mean.
Well, yes, Frank.
But but again, here's a conversation.
Like, people are coming for his voice.
Here's a conversation we've been having about the cult of musicians. Frank Ocean's cult is dedicated.
Oh yeah, next level.
And he never played a single one of his popular songs that everyone wants to hear from him. It's almost like he's saying fuck you to fans, and that's where I have an issue.
Yeah.
Because, like, bro,
there's a meme of a girl being like,
ankle.
Frank, you saved my life, and it's him being like, I hate you.
Yeah. That's exactly what it literally, just much like when we were young, when that got canceled.
And then no one did anything.
We just were like,
heartbroken.
Heartbroken. Yeah. It's the same thing. You pay outrageous prices to go see. And Frank knows this. He's fucking aware of it.
Especially when you're traveling. Because, like, Coachella is a place that you travel to. Just like Vegas.
Yes.
When we were young, it was canceled.
You plan this. You plan this right now. Yeah. Now people are planning for next year. That's just how it goes.
Yeah. Yeah. Immediately.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And so I think it's just a really... Sure, I'm not ever going to buy into that ankle bullshit, because I'm sorry. Florence and the Machine broke her foot. I watched her break her foot at Coachella. She performed the next week. Dave Grohl has come out in a fucking throne and played.
Yeah.
The man could have played. He was jumping around that stage.
It was supposed to be one of the biggest moments in music history.
And it failed.
And it was just such a heartbreaking...
letdown.
I'm watching girls just... I would be sobbing. I would be literally heartbroken.
Heartbroken.
So sad.
Livid.
And then, so he pulled out.
So he pulled out.
And then Blink 182.
Yep.
Took their spot.
Yes.
Which I watched their...
the comment section was going crazy.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know.
Oh,
but
okay,
I watched their live stream. And I thought that it was kind of fun.
Yeah.
It's like so Blink, but the best comment that I saw was like, it sounds like Tom DeLonge's trying to sound like Tom DeLonge.
Oh my God,
and
that
that was the best comment, because it does...
It's not mine.
Like, he really sounded like he was trying, but I guess it's because, like, no one's heard him sing those songs in fucking years.
Forever.
So it just is, it's like everyone's almost made fun of that. Mm-hmm. So I think that it's funny hearing him actually sing like
that. Way. I know.
Because
I know.
It's like, oh wow,
it's almost like a characterization in higher elevated
exactly.
kind of thing. Yeah.
Like, it's kind of a weird satire moment.
Almost.
But I thought that they were fun.
I think they're super fun.
I would have been there.
I would have been there for sure. Is Tom's voice the strongest?
It's never been the strongest.
It's never been the strongest, but, you know, I feel like because we're so spoiled with musicians having just the best voices nowadays, we forget that all those pop punk guys cannot sing to save their life.
It's truly. Not, they're not the best.
They're not singers.
Yeah. I mean, I feel like Matt from Alkaline Trio stepped in, and
has a good voice.
His voice is like, he came in and was like, oh, he's no Tom DeLonge because he doesn't have that.
It's not mine.
Yeah.
But
his voice, like, actually can.
Yes.
Blink-182 is such a...
Iconic. Sound.
Amazing.
Everyone knows every word to every song.
So I think
that even I feel like Tom forgot his own words.
Yeah, he did.
Point.
He had a moment.
Okay.
He had moments.
I was like, Tom, do you not remember your own music?
Yeah. It's been a while.
He's like dusting off the cobwebs.
Yeah. He's like, it's fine.
It's not mine. But we were all curious to see who the hell would replace Frank weekend two, because we know that man was not gonna come back. And the guys, hold my hand. I'm not fucking kidding you when I say Fred again played Coachella. It's fine.
He saved Coachella.
The FOMO. Ashley and I have been in Hawaii for a week
at
a wedding. Hard life.
As you can tell, I feel like I look a little tanner. Not as pale.
Yeah, you guys do look tan.
I covered my entire body up because no one needs to see my glorious tan.
Not a ghost
tan.
Like I was before.
Yeah, I don't want to shine everyone with this beautiful... melanin skin over here. Half melanin skin. You know?
Crushing it.
Thank you. But I can't believe that motherfucker...
Honestly,
pulled through.
The three of them together is so magical. They are so much fun.
Because they have so much fun on stage. Yeah, they're best friends.
They're what music is supposed to be. Yes.
We obviously all agree on this.
Yes.
And we're sad.
We're
all of us are so sad.
FOMO. I don't get FOMO. I'm like, whatever. I should be at wherever I need to be.
Oh, I get FOMO.
I just, you know, yeah, whatever. What I would have done.
I was on next level. Like,
we almost flew back home to.
Oh, to just leave immediately.
Yeah.
I was. If I wasn't exhausted.
You could have just flown into Palm Springs.
I know. Guys, Fred.
It looked really fun. I've seen a lot of clips.
Yeah.
They did so many fun remixes.
Oh, so good.
They played Rumble, which Sean is obsessed with.
So is Gabe. That was literally the only thing they could sing at the wedding.
Killers in the Jungle.
Killers in the Jungle. Gabe would just come up to me and be like, Killers in the Jungle. It's like, we get it. I love you. We get it.
Sean played it. I was like, we're on the bus. The bus is quiet. Yeah. He's like, Killers in the Jungle. It's like, duh, 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 duh. Killers in the Jungle. Like, oh my God. Anyways, big fans, you could say.
We could say.
I think that you're warming up to that Skrillex album.
I am.
I knew you would.
I know. I think for me, I still have to separate the Skrillex of old, the Sunny of old. And Skrillex now.
Yeah.
He has such a heavy Fred influence on him, though, now. Like, you know, I think it's... maybe, and that's just his evolution of music, because back in the day, Skrillex was like, Jesus Christ! Yeah, it was
very heavy, like, trap.
Yeah. Just intense...
Dubstep. Yes.
Womp, womp, womp.
Which he still does now, but they all kind of do it. It's like in and out. Like the drops are so heavy sometimes where you're like, oh my God.
Yeah.
Because Rumble's more like that. And there's also a lot of bangers on the album that are that still got that like wavy, like feel it in your soul.
Oh, yeah.
You're doing heavy drugs to
this. Yeah, I think.
Emotional, really.
Yeah, but honestly, maybe in a like a more palpable way.
Yeah.
Like my ears don't want to bleed every time I hear it.
Nightmare and Slander where it's like nails on a chalkboard.
Yes. Yeah. And the villagers are getting ready to murder someone.
It was quite the thing. Yeah, I saw Nightmare and Slander, and literally, you ought to be a tough cookie for that.
Man, my ears would start bleeding.
It literally felt like we just murdered a village below, and we all ran up to the Red Rocks, and we were like, nails on a chalkboard, just like, yeah. I was like, this is fucking terrifying.
This is my favorite Ashley story, by the way.
It's really the hard metal of electronic music. Like everyone's just headbanging and they love the pain.
Yeah.
I'm like, all of our pitchforks. It's fine.
It's fine.
I get it.
But that's I do have a hard time sometimes remembering, like, okay, that was old Skrillex. He can be in the past. So like I think listening to a new album where I was like, I like this, and then I don't know. I don't trust you yet. Almost kind of thing.
The trust issues.
Skrillex, I don't trust you yet. Keep coming out with songs like that, and maybe we can talk. Just saying.
I love that album.
I know. But honestly, what an incredible replacement. They, as Rachel has been saying to us, saved Coachella.
Yeah, because people were pissed, and I think that people were, like, not so pissed after.
Well, yeah, because you get fucking Fred against Skrillex and Forte.
It's just, like, a huge party.
And they're all just best friends, and Fred's energy. I'm telling you.
Oh, my God.
That man radiates greatness.
I know, he does. Yes. He's such a superstar.
Yes.
What's so funny, too, I saw this video of Forte, and he was like, I saw Ariana Grande walk down this, like...
Oh, yes!
He's, like, walking down, and they, like, zoom in on his face, and he's just, like, so...
But didn't Fred or something say, like, this was not, like, this was a genuine reaction? He didn't know he was being filmed.
Oh,
and so it was literally just, that's him.
Aw,
that's Kieran for Forte. And I think that's
sweet,
like,
sweet baby
adorable.
Angel. Yeah. So, I mean, all in all...
Interesting.
Sunday would have been, I think... my fave day.
Yeah.
Blackpink would have been really fun.
It would have been fun. I'm just not a huge K-pop, J-pop person. So it just doesn't float my boat.
Yeah. How you like that?
I do love that. Oh my. I do get down that song.
But I'm talking about Kali's album.
Kali Mesa?
No.
Kali.
Oh my God, the last name. Oh, Uchis?
Oh, yeah. Yes, yes, yes.
She,
yes, yes.
Her performance looked amazing. Oh, I'm going to talk about it because I'm talking about her album because I have to.
I saw her live.
No, it's a banger of an album. It's a banger of an album.
The album's amazing.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
Anyways. Coachella, great. For later. I'd love to hear if you guys went. We didn't see a lot of people go.
Why?
Our feeds were very, like, dry on the Coachella.
I'm parched of Coachella.
Because usually our feeds are fucking slammed with Coachella content. Well, so this year,
from influencers, I saw nothing.
Yeah,
and I feel like they got such shit last year.
Oh, yeah, so maybe they're like,
maybe it calmed down.
Yeah, maybe. Maybe did Revolve even do a fest?
They did.
I saw nothing.
I saw a couple of posts, and the posts that I saw were like, I forget who there was, like, it was like Pink Panthers, and there was nobody at their sets. Nobody was giving energy. There's a video of Pink Panthers being like, come on, you guys. Like, she's
no,
like,
fucking way. To Pink Panthers?
Yeah, like, and it was all a Revolve. Like, because I'm sure she played the actual Coachella stages, but the Revolve Fest, they had their own, like, kind of segue and, like, an own separate kind of thing. And there was nobody at the sets. And the videos that were going viral from it were, like, so embarrassed. Like, the people were like, this is so embarrassing to be here. Like, oh.
Thank God. Yeah.
Maybe the influencer death is coming.
I'm telling you, the
I literally saw three posts on Revolve Fest, and it was like the same content. Like, wow. It was, yeah.
What? That is wild. Yeah. There's something in my eye. Hold on.
The power of being a hater is so real.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
It's next level.
Yeah.
Because did you hear? So this is complete sidebar, but talk about being a hater. Vanessa and Nick are
they're
no longer
get fired. Here.
Oh, yeah.
They're gonna get fired.
That. A win.
That is the tea that the people needed.
We've been well, Cameron and Lauren, I want them to be.
They're saying.
I know. Ugh. Thank God, because they would be so amazing. But
because they're actually good fucking people, and my God,
I didn't know Vanessa was a host of TRL.
Yeah.
I did not know that.
Yeah. I think I told you this. I recently watched a clip of Newlyweds. Whenever it was Jessica Simpson and Nick Lachey. Nick Lachey is actually an abusive piece of shit.
Oh,
like mentally.
Oh, well, I remember
so
when I watched,
mean to her.
I remember when I watched that. Like it was such like a scary show to watch because the abuse was like so aggressive.
But I didn't even realize
because
it
was like early 2000s.
Yes,
no one cared about women.
No, he literally talked. They were like, he basically was like, "You're an idiot. You're dumb." And poor little Jessica Simpson, who we all thought was dumb, gets is tuna event. We all, you know, that whole fucking line. But now I'm siding with Jessica Simpson. I'm
poor,
like,
yeah.
Fuck you, Nick Lachey. Who do you think you are? So now I'm on team fuck Nick Lachey.
Okay, well.
And Vanessa.
A lot of people are. And I cannot believe it because the finale was.
A shit show.
It was just
the reunion was a shit show.
The live stream didn't cut out.
I know. Wait, the live stream didn't cut out?
Oh. I thought it did cut out.
Oh, yes. Yeah, it did cut out. In the beginning. I thought you meant at the end.
Oh, yeah.
No. Yeah, no, it didn't work.
No.
But anyways, Sidebar Nation.
Well, he is in music.
Oh, yeah, he's in 98 Degrees.
You know? Well, she made some awkward comment about it at the reunion.
Oh, yeah, because they said bye, bye, bye. And then she was like, none of that around here.
God. And then asked everyone if they were going to have babies. Like, what era are we in?
You're so weird.
Who even said? It was Brett who was like, we're taking it slow, and you know, I don't think that's a conversation. I was like, thank you.
Someone else was also like, we don't need to talk about this. Yes. I think it was Tiffany.
Tiffany and Brett. They love them. Get it.
Gang.
Anyone watching Love is Blind?
Anyways, everyone is. What are you talking about?
True. Yeah. Okay, Ashley has a new little series for us. Please explain it.
So, because I'm on TikTok a lot, and my algorithm is all like music TikToks, I thought it would be a fun segment for us to start having me surprise Kelson Rage on the podcast with my music talks, and then we could talk about them. So I don't know what we should call this segment yet. This is the very beginning, but it's going to be like Ashley's TikToks or something like that.
TikTok corner, TikTok, tits for TikTok, TikTok tits. No, that's not
you get shadow banned immediately.
Tits for TikTok.
Okay. So, do you want me to play them on my laptop?
I feel like we should play them here. Just bigger screen.
Yeah,
bigger
screen. So these are all related to music and they are pretty funny. Okay. So let's start off with that first one over
with
there.
With this one or this one?
That one.
Okay.
So this one's pretty great. Okay. So.
Oh my God. I already love this.
Oh, I've seen this one.
I saw that. Anything P Pedro Pascal, where he's, it's literally always him being like, eating this damn, what is he even eating, a sandwich? Yes. It's just so fucking funny.
So this video is of Noah Kahan.
Yeah.
And he fell off the stage during one of his shows. And he has Pedro Pascal eating the sandwich, that iconic cap cut edit that everyone is using. But it's so funny. And it says, me on a Tuesday at 12:13 p.m. remembering the time I almost lost my life. And it's Noah Kahan falling off the
stage. But isn't that so fucking true? Where you're just sitting there and you're like, remember when I almost like, it's so intrusive.
Yeah.
You're like, where?
Yeah, you're like, why? Why is this coming back right now at 12:30?
Yeah. On a Tuesday.
Yeah.
Eating a sandwich.
Yeah.
That is amazing.
So that's...
Well, we're big Noah fans here.
Yeah, we're huge Noah fans, so I thought it was looking good.
By the way, he's coming out with a new single I saw.
Oh, thank God, because I miss him.
I'd miss that.
I just heard it on TikTok. See?
Oh, got it.
Tits for TikTok.
Shadow banned.
Are we doing this one?
Yes.
Yeah!
Okay, so I'm sure everyone's already heard this.
Yes.
13 million people, 14 million.
Yeah. If I were a fish,
shimmering in the sun, it's a rare one, can't believe that I caught one.
Look at that fish, heaviest in the sea.
Why is everybody on the internet so mean?
We don't know.
I was going through and I saw me.
Ooh, that was a good little yodel at the end.
Singing that song. I'd say damn, they're cute. Let's sing along.
Oh!
So cute.
So cute.
Fish.
So that's the iconic Karuk, who I actually saw open for.
Oh!
Yeah, I told you that.
I don't remember.
She opened for Madeline. What's her name? God. Zam.
Oh, Maddie Zam.
Yeah, you Zam. Did see this. You
so
see this.
They opened for Maddie Zam.
Oh.
And wonderful.
Yeah.
So much fun.
I didn't know they had other songs.
Snakes. Okay, so they're already big on TikTok.
Okay.
Karuk.
Okay.
Like 100K followers. Now almost a million.
Damn.
God bless. That's what going viral is all about. They already released this song.
Yes, I did see that.
And I saw another TikTok. Oh, also Olivia Barton is singing.
Yeah.
And we love Olivia.
We love Olivia.
Olivia's amazing. So.
I did just get your vinyl in the mail and I'm so excited to play it.
So just such a fun song. But I saw another TikTok that was saying Gen Z is going to be obsessed when they hear about the Juno soundtrack. Because literally the song Bumblebee.
Yes. By Kimbra. Or no.
Oh my gosh.
I know what you're talking about. That entire Juno soundtrack. I can tell that we are gonna be friends.
Yeah. It goes like. Yeah. If I was a flower going round and tree, all I wanted you to be, my sweet honeybee.
All I want is you. Yep.
Yep. That's the All I Want Is You by Barry Lewis. Polisar. But like that whole soundtrack has got fucking bangers on it, and that's like kind of the same vibe.
I can tell that we are gonna be friends.
Yeah,
that's that song too.
Yep. So there's a bunch on that soundtrack. So the Juno soundtrack also, if you like If I Was a Fish, but that song is now available on Spotify. So
fuck yeah,
such a cute feel good song.
It is an ear.
Oh my god, it actually hurts.
I've
like added Alf's name to it. It's kind of taking on different forms.
I'm now
sometimes
gonna
I say if I was a bitch, it like
I were a bitch, I would.
Yeah, sometimes it just like it's just turning around in my brain.
This is how we're gonna do therapy. We're like sing your feeling. If I were an asshole.
Remix.
Heavy metal version.
So
I fucking love the song. I love that it's blowing up. I love Olivia Barton. I'm so happy she's getting the recognition she deserves.
100% opening for Lizzie McGovern right now.
Just what a cool little duo.
Yeah.
I love that TikTok kind of makes friendships and we get to see these, and then when they break up, oh my god, there's so much scary breakup drama on TikTok happening right now.
Not between them.
No. I'm just saying, like, you know, I feel like you get to see these people, like, live their lives, mm-hmm. and we're all rooting for them. And when anything tragic happens,
yeah. No,
we're
it's
like,
heartbreaking.
Yeah. You know?
Yeah, so, totally.
I love this duo. Let's keep doing with the songs, girls.
Okay, so next one is kind of a fun one.
Okay.
So this is...
Oh, God.
This is AI is now making covers with the people's voices.
What? I hate this shit. This could be a whole hot take in it of itself. Yeah,
so okay. Just listen. Okay. Hey there, Delilah, what's it like in New York City? Okay, wait, pause it, because we got to say... Okay, so that was Kanye West.
I mean, people are going to see this video.
Oh, well, not listening.
Oh, yes, the poor listeners.
So that was Kanye West. And then the next one's Juice WRLD. It doesn't... This is Drake. So this is Biggie. That sounds... It's just like, that's Michael Jackson.
Can I say something about this?
Yeah, yes. Just an interesting take on what's going on.
In AI. The music industry and AI. All of my, I was talking about this with someone the other day. My For You page has all been AI and music. One of the worst things about it is like, I'm hearing this song, but it's not made by, you know, Little Uzi and Juice, what I'm trying to, and it just like freaks. It's just not, I feel like it's so invasive. Like, I don't know. Ooh,
interesting thought.
It makes me just, I guess, upset because it's not their song. They didn't make it. Like, that's just their voice. Like, that has nothing to do with them at the end of the day, but I'm like, I love it because it's their voices, but I'm also like, it's not, I don't know. I just,
especially for the ones that have, you know, passed, like Tupac.
Yeah.
You know, it's like,
Juice, yeah.
Is that fair?
No.
Michael Jackson?
I don't think it's fair at all.
It's almost like how we talk about all the time when it's like Juice WRLD, for example. Another having single. 1,000 fucking albums and 1,000 singles come out post-death.
Yeah.
Just talk about this too.
I hate that.
It's almost like...
I would hate if someone did that to me in my craft. Yeah. I'd be like, why are you releasing this shit?
Because clearly it didn't want to be released. You know?
There's something weird about it.
And he's not AI here to even say anything. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, he's not here to give his opinion on people using his voice and releasing his fucking music.
Yeah.
I don't want to hear the bullshit. Oh, well, he said... He's not here right now saying that. Yeah. So.
And I think that's the whole issue around AI right now is the morals and ethics.
Yeah.
That there's no boundaries right now.
No, it's scary because you could just, like, totally do the deep fake face.
On anything.
Yeah. If your face is like online at all, like people can just totally use your face.
And who isn't online?
Yeah.
That's a thing.
Yeah, no, it's
like they've got us all on.
Yeah, they've got us all.
This is my conspirator face. Yeah. They've got us all. They're going to blackmail everyone. This is Black Mirror shit.
Oh my God.
New season.
I know. I was about to say, I would love to watch like a Black Mirror episode on AI. I feel like there's weird shit there.
Oh, yeah.
You know, like just fuck me up, Black Mirror. Make my thoughts. Dark.
It's scary. So this is kind of a fun.
Okay, this is
so pauses. So this is kind of an interesting thing, and I have more to talk about after you watch this. So
okay, this is
it.
Insane. Did Miley Cyrus release a secret album the same day as Endless Summer Vacation? I would never normally release a video looking this absolutely haggard, but I just woke up and there's this album called Hands of Time released by a girl named Clara Pierce, and give it a listen. There is no way that this is not Miley Cyrus. As you can see, it was released on March 10th, 2023. Same exact day as Endless Summer Vacation. And when you type in Clara Pierce online, zero entries. Who has zero entries and has made an entire produced album? Okay, but if there was any doubt, just listen.
Okay.
Interesting.
So I did some deep diving.
Deep diving.
And if you look here, so I have this, I went to the Spotify.
Uh-huh.
And the album was there. I saved it and then they took it down. So after this went viral on TikTok, because a lot of people started talking about, here's the album, nothing.
What?
So I think someone leaked Miley's unreleased music.
No.
I really think that because literally once people started talking about it on TikTok, the album got deleted.
You know what would be super interesting? If she releases an extended version and it's like all those songs.
Yeah, there was like 12 songs unreleased. And there was a bunch of TikToks where people were saying like, she's like name dropped these things. Like these are related. And
I love a good music conspiracy.
And it sound like it's her. 100%.
Is it AI?
I'm just kidding. Yeah, it's
clear. Therein goes the dark
circle.
I know.
Dang. See, it could have been. But it sounds
No, that's her. Exactly. No, like no. Her. And it's hard to sound like Miley. Mm-hmm. Like, it, she has a weird twang that is only apparent on certain words.
And it's, like, kind of raspy. Very, like, vocal fry of California.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, it's very much.
Ashley.
I know.
I have got to dig into this conspiracy further.
It's deleted. Amazing. There's, like, little. There's. If you look up Miley Cyrus and then that girl's name, yeah. Claire Pierce, I'm sure you'll find TikToks.
Oh, I'm going to find
it.
A Reddit subreddit.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, Reddit
will Redditors have the will deets. Know.
Yeah.
They'll have the. We'll circle back. No,
we'll circle
week.
Back. Yeah, see what we found.
I am. Oh, my. That was a good one to end on.
Yeah, so that's Ashley's TikTok corner. Hopefully, you guys are, if you're listening, you're able to understand. And if you're watching, it's fine.
Yeah, let us know.
We're going to get headphones in the future, so then maybe our audio will be a little bit better when we're watching videos. But
who knows? That was great. Thank you.
That was so good.
Moving on to our podcast feature song. This is a great one by the super sweet, super lovable Angel Abaya. Her song Better came out. It's actually part of an EP. Mm-hmm. She came out with it, I think like a month or so ago. And let me tell you, if you're looking for that light, surfy vibes.
Very light, very chill.
Lo-fi, low chill, you know, kind of mood.
Low chill.
Oh my God, this song
that's a good genre.
Is for you, my friends. Angel Abaya's record is called The Bubble, so go check it out. But she is really, really interesting. This is all about different orbs we place ourselves in, so like groups, cities, relationships, etc. How all the feelings can feel, you know, isolating, happy, super stoked. And sometimes you just want to pop that bubble and kind of move on to a different bubble. You know what I mean?
That is a great way to describe how this song sounds.
Yes.
Yeah.
Bubbly. But like lo-fi
bubbly.
But also
like it kind of like just takes away all that shit that you want to get out of and then takes you into this new bubble.
Beautiful. She had yerba. It's a really, really, really cool song. She is a Filipino-American singer-songwriter based in LA. And she released, she's actually releasing the full debut album of The Bubble May 5th.
Mark your calendars. I think that this actually comes out
the week after. Yes, I agree.
Yeah.
So congratulations on your release, Angel. Super stoked to listen to it. She spent a lot of her time around the music scene of Boise, Idaho. So if you're a Boiseanite, I love that. Go.
What is the music scene like in Boise,
super
Idaho?
Super curious now. And she is just really big into working for like local organizations out there, like Tree Fort. We actually had Grocer come in, and they played at Tree Fort Festival too. So we love her. We love a little full circle.
Yeah, I hear Tree Fort's dope.
I've heard that too. Maybe we
go.
Maybe we say hey.
To go to Boise.
I have
my
too.
Cousins live there. Let's go.
Spokane's right there.
Oh, brilliant.
We love it. So this is Angel Abaya with her song Better. We hope you enjoy. Stream it on all platforms. We'll be right back with some new music discoveries. We can't wait to chit-chat with you all about.
Thank you.
And we're back.
Yeah! Ash, let's dive into some music, babe. Let's do this.
Yeah. Okay. Do you want me to start?
I think you started last week, last time.
I don't remember.
I don't recall.
Sure. I can start.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Okay. So my first pick is what we were talking about before. I know my whole body vibrated. I was like, Kali Uchis.
Yes.
And her album Red Moon and Venus. Fuck
me.
Yeah, and yeah. I missed it for our March top albums. I know.
It was very close, but it's a...
I didn't listen to it yet. I just listened to it. So I, like, would have had it.
Yeah.
If I would have listened.
Yeah.
It's a fucking banger album.
Yes.
Like, literally, so if I could rate it 10 out of 5, I would.
Wow.
Every song, I just, like, was like...
Whoop. Swooped it in?
Yeah.
Man, you have been queen of R&B this year. Grae, now Kali.
Yeah, it's oof. Like... Latin pop,
yeah.
R&B, yeah. Just a queen, and I cannot get enough. She's Colombian-American pop star. This is her third studio album. It was released in March, so yes. Definitely top probably of year.
Yeah. Oops. So sorry.
I tapped it. Mm-hmm. I got to stop tapping.
I got booped.
I'm tip-tapping. like we were talking about, she performed at Coachella, and when she performed, she brought on Tyler the Creator, jeez. Omar Apollo, and Don Toliver. I'm like, Jesus,
that was Rachel's face right now.
No, her set was incredible.
Because that's her man's. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Her wait, who's her man?
Don Toliver.
Oh, I didn't know they were dating.
They're like power couple. Callie's been one of my faves forever. I saw her at Coachella like 4 years ago, and she brought out Tyler. She was at a smaller set like during the day.
Oh, how cute.
Was that so before or after she blew up with telepathy?
Before.
Or, isn't that?
Oh, yeah. Way before that, yeah.
Yeah, so.
She clearly has a connection with Tyler the Creator then.
Yeah, they've been making music for a minute.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's just awesome. And she's so she's cool. Obviously, I'm glad to see her like... I mean, she's already huge.
Yeah.
That's why I wasn't going to talk about
couple.
This, but I just loved it so much. I just have to... Woo! Yeah,
power love
couple.
The power couple.
It's
a very sensual album.
Oh my gosh.
Does she
it's
talk
sensual,
about that?
It's sensual, but it's also like almost Sade-ish. Like it has like very much like those vibes, but then she gets a little funky and a little bit upbeat with that Don Toliver song that she's fantasy. Oh my God, it's so good. It's a little more upbeat. She's on tour right now. Guess who's her opener?
Who?
Grae. I know.
I called
Can you
that.
Imagine?
You guys didn't know that?
Yeah, I did not know that.
Yeah.
The tour started already, I think a couple days ago, like after Coachella. She's not coming to LA or San Diego.
Are you fucking kidding me?
So I think we're going to have to fly to Vegas or Arizona because...
Can we do Arizona? You know
Vegas.
Me. Vegas.
Maybe we'll have to fly to Phoenix.
I'm down for
or
that.
Or drive. Road
you know
trip.
I love a road trip.
Maybe road trip. Yeah. That'd be great.
I would love that.
Because... Literally,
no. I have to see Grae.
The two of them together, that would be like
a power couple. That's a power couple.
Yeah, that's a power couple. Like insane.
How many tears would we cry at that show?
Too many, or just enough?
Or just enough.
I've literally added every song to my favorite. My tops are Moonlight, Blue, Fantasy, but like literally,
yeah, all of it.
It's all good. So good. It's all. If you haven't listened to it yet, go check it out. It's really just such a fantastic album. And it got over an 8 on Pitchfork.
Whoa, calm down, Pitchfork writers.
Yeah, damn.
I know, I've never seen that, I don't think.
No, it's rare. I think it's really cool, though, when we do talk about, like, bigger artists like her, it's always because their album is so good.
Like, I have to say something.
Yeah, exactly.
It's deserved.
Yes.
It's really, like, one that you should just buy and listen to it all day, every
day. Oh, I love that. On vinyl?
Yeah.
Oh, I love that idea.
Or CD or cassette, you know, whatever you...
Tape deck, A-track. My first pick of the week is another female artist, actually one from our inbox, and
I didn't know this was an inboxer.
Yes.
Yeah, I listened to this album.
I done got blasted away. Cami Kehoe with her album Drama Queen. It's everything I wanted in like an alt pop rock kind of album. She's 19.
God, jeez, what?
Damn it. Yeah, I know. Here we go.
Amazing.
This is her debut album, which is super fucking cool. It's called Drama Queen, like I said, and it's just this glorious blend of funk, pop, alt pop, R&B, a little rock. Like, it's got everything you really want in a full album, mm-hmm. especially as a debut, because she's just showcasing and highlighting all of her talent.
Kind of, like, goes through different genres.
Which a Bartice, really, you know me, I'm like, give me that. I should say she does it well, too. There are some people who are like, Jesus, stick to one genre. But, like, this girl does it well. She has the whole album is like a concept. It's the beginning and end of a relationship. There's a lot of fuck you kind of moments, which I love. And it's just really a beautiful, beautiful world of music that she created, and it feels very personal. And like we feel allowed to listen to it. It's so cool. And she is honestly a sweet baby angel. I've chatted with her a little bit. Her album has just blew me away. Blew me away. And for a debut album at 19, that's just applause. That's
it's
just
really applause. Good.
It is. It's just great. So my favorite songs off of it are, mostly all of it. Love Songs Volume 1, Break My Heart, and Hate Your Fucking Self.
Hate Your Fucking Self is a banger.
And it's the last song on the album, mm-hmm. so I think that's even more brilliant.
Because I was listening, and then that came on, and I was like, oh, what is this?
Yeah, right? That's when you...
Ending with an alt-pop anthem is always a good choice.
Amen, sister friend.
Nice.
So, Cami Kehoe with her album called Drama Queen, which I've not been told I'm a drama queen ever in my life. Boop.
I love. I'm just like... okay, great.
Okay, great.
I have another debut album up next by Taylor Jansen.
Okay.
And her album, I Live in Patterns. Okay.
Oh, God.
This album is incredible. It's another March album I missed.
Oops.
I'm so sorry.
Guys, March was wild.
There's so too many.
There's too many.
But I'm so happy I found Taylor. Never heard of her before. Don't even really know how she came up on my album.
That's a deep find.
I don't know.
I sure didn't.
She's very much like indie rock pop. Sounds a lot like Carly Hansen.
Oh, and you're on a Carly Hansen kick.
I'm obsessed.
Yeah.
So this was like, oh my God, yeah. Relatable lyrics, beautiful vocals. Where are we going? Oh, I'm getting a phone call.
Decline.
Mom.
We're podcasting, Lisa.
And she is 23 year old. So we love that. Debut album from Winnipeg. Rachel's like, feel it. The album is greatly influenced by her growing up in an evangelical gospel church.
Oh,
so
fuck.
We love religious trauma.
We love religious trauma.
Yeah, that's, you know, you're going to be relating to
Should
this.
We just call the show Religious Trauma Dump?
Seriously.
It's not solely about how awful it was, but more of like the journey through that and how she's grown into the person she is today because of it.
Oh, I love that.
Yeah. So it's really good. Definitely one to watch.
Okay.
We tagged her in my,
I did see that.
On rotation, and she is such a sweet baby angel.
They always are.
And, she's amazing.
I need to add this to my list.
Add it.
I missed
it. It's from March, but that's, still add it.
I still
back.
Have a lot of March albums.
I know, same. So I might have missed a few others.
We'll see. We'll find out next week.
My favorites are I Live in Patterns, Push It Down, and Designated Driver.
Hell yes. I'm excited to listen to that one.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
Cool, cool. My next little offering is Pio Hartnett with his EP called Cargo. And Ashley, you're going to need to listen.
I know,
listen.
I'm adding this right now.
Thank you. So this little man is, not little, this man, I was like, that's rude, Kelsey. This man is from Galway. So we love an Irish boy.
Oh, gosh, nice.
I know, he's an indie pop artist. And he's really taken my entire soul with him in his very soul, not laid back, I want to call it.
Okay.
Laid back EP. And not in a bad way.
I see Dermot Kennedy referencing your notes.
Yes, ma'am.
I haven't talked about him in forever.
I'm bringing him back for you.
Where have you been?
He released that album. he has.
That you probably still never listened to.
I did. I did listen to. Pio is really, really dope. He has these really warm piano lines. He's got like the heart-wrenching lyrics that Ashley's obsessed with. And like an indie folk sound kind of on top of that as well.
Oh, that sounds like
Irish. He just sounds Irish. I do too. It's ridiculous. He has been working in the Irish music scene for a little bit, making kind of a huge splash. He won like some Guinness Music Award thing, which is kind of cool. Playing at some bigger venues, opening up for some bigger bands. Really, really just kind of starting to thrive in his music career. And I wrote that this EP is for those who enjoy the surfy vibes of Goth Babe.
Love it.
The lyrics of Sven. Mm-hmm. And the attitude of Dermot Kennedy.
Oh, the attitude. Mm.
You know how Dermot gets a little sad, but he's a happy guy?
Yeah.
Same exact thing. I think this is all... I think this is an Irish
feeling. Those are three men that I love. I know. So I'm dialing in.
I think... Yeah, honestly, just an incredible EP. I was super just like taken aback by how... It's very easy. It's just like we've been talking about. It's just like a palate cleanser mm-hmm. in the best ways possible. It's light. It's airy. There's a little tragedy. We love that. But like, it's a good, well-written album. Oh, EP, I said. So my favorite songs off of it are Hooligans and I Don't Mind. It's Nice to Make New Friends. Which I think is the funniest title.
That's
of
fun.
A, yeah.
That's
yeah.
fun.
Pio Hartnett. Tater Snoring is... We should just put a mic on him at this point.
Oh.
You literally can't hear him. It's so weird.
Really?
Yeah.
Nice. Anyways.
Moving on.
Sorry. Moving on. My final album.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, this is Mauro's album, Hortella.
Okay.
And so
I know nothing about this.
Okay, great.
I know. Teach me.
Oh my God. I'll teach you. Mauro is Portuguese singer-songwriter. She's mostly known for her collaborations with multiple artists such as Odessa, the song Better Now.
Oh!
And the Paper Kites, Walk Above the City.
Mm. Oh!
Yeah.
Those are very interesting collaborations.
Yes. Yeah. I mean, she has a stunning voice. Her voice is absolutely stunning, almost like comforting. It's very soft. In her album, Hortella, meaning meant, she really changes up her song to be more raw, acoustic, and emotional. Ooh. So her last album that came out last year, so she's just cranking it out.
As they do.
Can You See Me? It's very, like, it's more upbeat, kind of pop sounding.
Okay.
And this album is way different. It is
love that.
Acoustic, very slowed down, just like stunning. It's mostly in Portuguese. There's like a few English songs.
I love
it's kind of
like
I feel
language.
Like you get like an Arouge vibe from this. Like you don't know what they're saying, but it's
but
stunning,
it's beautiful, and you're just like, what are you doing?
What are you doing to me? Is exactly what it sounds like.
Yeah, I love that.
Most of the songs are about love, and it's just like a really
cool,
and it's just a really. Stunning piece of work.
Oh, I'm listening to this immediately.
Oh, you have to.
Yeah.
It's really good. And I have heard of Mauro before, but just like I watched a few music videos, she seems like such a sweet baby angel.
I didn't know she was like, Portuguese.
Yeah.
That's cool.
And yeah, she's like probably been in songs that you've heard of before. She's done a lot of like just vocal inserts into a bunch of
that fucking Odessa songs.
A banger and huge.
And huge.
So Mauro on that Better Now song, she just released an album. And
hell yeah.
My favorite songs are Hortella, Oxala, and Something About Tomorrow.
See, I love listening to music in other languages, especially when I'm reading.
Yeah.
Because it's like, I can't listen to anything with lyrics.
Yes.
But I need music.
Yeah, so this is perfect.
This is perfect.
Yeah.
And because I'm sick of listening to my Harry Potter themed playlist. I'm like, we get it, Harry. Calm down. You know, sometimes you just want like a pop, indie pop, rock album that just you don't understand the lyrics.
Yeah,
to.
No, that's this. There's like two songs in English on it.
Great.
But her last album is mostly in English.
Oh.
So she's just a
how
a lady of many trades. She's very gifted.
I love that. My final album EP, it's an EP, is the...
It looks long.
It looks long, short. I think it's like 20 minutes at tops.
25 minutes. It has like 8 songs on it.
Yeah.
I was like, what?
I know. Well, there's an intro.
Oh,
you know
what
I mean? When it's like that.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
Yeah. So there's some swiftness happening.
Got it.
This is Hannah Grae with her album EP titled Hell is a Teenage Girl. Amen.
Yeah.
Let me tell you, she is a spitfire.
Oh.
She is 22. She is using her debut EP to work through the less than happy memories of being a girl in high school.
Oh, and boy. I wish I could have written songs in high school.
I literally say I wish I had this EP for when I was a teenage girl, because my God, I would have felt so seen, you know? And so like, oh, thank you.
Yeah, someone
I
feel like gets it.
My hormones are just going insane.
Yeah.
She has the iconic 2000s pop punk vibe. Mm-hmm. Her voice especially. It's very, she calls it bratty, where is it? Bratty pop music, I think.
I love that.
And I think it's hilarious. It's very much riot girl music for now. We keep kind of thinking about this. Coming back to
that, yeah.
We really are seeing a lot of that influence come back. And I felt it all over this EP. Obviously a little angsty, because teenage girls are hella angsty. Yeah. I was one.
Yes.
She states her sound blends bratty pop rock with musical theater.
Oh, that's your jam.
My jam. But not musical theater in the way you're thinking, I think. I think just because all it feels so like big. It's a production.
Yes.
It's a whole vibe.
Experience.
And what an experience. And what bratty ass teenage girl wasn't so involved in that world?
Yeah.
Like your own selfish
Yeah.
Yeah. So one of just the coolest EPs I listened to recently. I'm really, really digging it. She is my one to watch for sure. Especially
that.
With her sound and that pop punk vibe.
I added it to my list.
You're going to dig it. You're going to dig it. You can dig it.
You're going to dig it.
Island time, baby. My favorite tracks, honestly, the entire thing. But Time of Your Life, Never Say No, and Beneath Your Jeans, that song will murder you. That song will crush your soul.
Oh, I'm listening to this on the drive home.
I'm just saying, think about what Beneath Your Jeans sounds like, it would be about. And yeah, it's,
oh,
it's
shit.
Devastating.
Oh, no.
Yeah. You know, creepy men in high school.
Yeah. Boy, were there a lot of those.
It's
running sideways. I just felt like we were a newscaster.
And anyways, back to you, Bob, over in the studio.
It's running sideways.
But that is actually the end of our beautiful little new music discovery corner with your girls. We are so happy to be here. We're wrapping up our season pretty shortly, but we have some really cool guests that are going to come on and chit-chat with us.
2 months.
Yeah, that's wrap. I mean, month and a half.
Really?
Yeah, because I think we're done recording in June. Remember we talked about midway through June.
Yeah.
It's like a month and a half.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, you're getting girl music episodes until
really
the end of June.
I know.
Don't leave us. But we have some really exciting guests coming up. Some really cool conversations, I think, surrounding the music industry. We will be doing At Home With starting in July as well.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll be kind of pumping that out for the next few weeks of information.
You guys, we have received some of the dopest
artists
for our At Home With. It's going to be very hard to decide who we choose for it. I just appreciate everyone sending in their submissions. Like, I know that takes a lot of time, and we have over 130.
Yeah.
So it's going to be very difficult for us to narrow it down because we love all of you guys so much. But yeah, it's crazy. It's pretty fucking nuts.
It's pretty fucking dope. I will say, like, we didn't expect to have this response, and we're just so excited to really get to deep dive into an artist each week.
You know,
give them the attention they deserve. Give them the spotlight of our page, essentially.
Totally.
And it's one of our favorite things to do every summer. So we really hope you guys will tune in, support the artists, and supporting them supports us. So we really appreciate you all the time. Don't forget, we always have merch on the website. Blah, 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 blah. We are always looking for new music, so if you want to submit your music, our inbox is always open.
Mm-hmm.
Don't be afraid to say hi to us. We love chit-chatting about music. We enjoy recommendations.
Yes.
We enjoy the playlists you all make. Like, just send everything to us. We love it. So just think of us as your fun music aunts.
We love it.
We love you.
We're here for you.
We're here for you, baby. Have a great week, everybody. We'll see you next week.
Bye.